हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ सेम स्टार ग्लोबल स्कूल. माई सेल्फ प्रतिमा सिंह एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर 24. दिस इज़ फ्रॉम सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल लाइफ, प्रेजुडिस, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंड इनइक्वालिटी. सो द टॉपिक्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डू द रिविजन आर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, प्रेजुडिस, स्टीरियोटाइप्स, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंड इनइक्वालिटी, मल्टीपल आइडेंटिटीज़, कास्ट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन इंडिया, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर फॉर एबॉलिशिंग कास्ट सिस्टम एंड इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड डाइवर्सिटी. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आर रिविजन विद द टॉपिक डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. सो वॉट इज़ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन? इट इज़ द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ ट्रीटिंग अ पर्सन और अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल लेस फेयरली देन द अदर्स. इट मीन्स treating a group of people in a less favorable manner than others, or debarring someone from certain facilities only because of difference in religion, gender, caste or regional origin is called discrimination. Like for example, discrimination can be based on gender. Like a girl is treated inferior from boys. A girl is not allowed to select a career, but boys are. Or if girls are not allowed to wear Western dresses, which boys are allowed in some families, then this is discrimination based on gender. Then the second example is that discrimination can be on the basis of religion also. Like a person belonging to a particular religion is not allowed to enter some public places, especially places of worship. So this is religion-based discrimination. Then the most important is caste-based discrimination. Division of caste had made people bound to perform the jobs that are allotted to that caste. As we all know that in our society, the caste system is divided into four parts, which we will discuss later. Then the second topic is that what is prejudice? When someone judges another person in a negative way, it is called prejudice. We form unreasonable opinion about a person without much thought or knowledge. People have certain prejudices about other people who may be different. This difference can be in terms of facial features, accent, eating habits, or clothes. For example, if we say that a person from Bihar is usually considered as less intelligent and they are also treated in an ill-mannered way sometimes. So this is prejudice. Then the second one is stereotypes. So what is stereotypes? When we create a fixed idea that people have about someone or something which is often not true. In many ways, it is like a prejudice and results in people discriminating against other people, groups, communities, etc. Sometimes stereotypes may happen unconsciously without our realization. Some of the examples of stereotypes are like, for example, girls are supposed to be soft-spoken. They cry too often. They need to learn cooking, doing household works. But boys are supposed to be aggressive. They are supposed to have interest in adventurous sports. They should not cry because crying is a sign of weakness. So this example shows that we are stereotyping girls as well as boys. But girls have been stereotyped in a negative way, but boys in a positive way. So, stereotyping can be positive as well as negative. Now, the next topic is that how discrimination and inequality are interrelated. So, discrimination can be on the basis of religion, race, caste, gender, and region. And discrimination also leads to inequality because all people are not allowed to lead their life in a respectful manner. Discrimination also creates difference between persons on the basis of wealth, like poor people are not able to fulfill their basic needs and are also treated badly, they don't get respect. And this discrimination leads to the backwardness in the society. Now, the fifth topic is multiple identities. So, prejudice and stereotypes affects the human relationship. These two elements influences the thinking of people as they start thinking about others on the basis of a particular identity that the individual poses. But no one should make a perception about someone on the basis of a particular or single identity, but the different identities of every person should be considered before making a particular mindset. So this is about the multiple identities. Now we will talk about the caste discrimination in India. So, in our society, caste system is divided into four main castes on the basis of the occupation. And the first three castes, that is Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaish, are treated or supposed to be the higher caste because of the functions or the occupation that they used to perform. And the members of the fourth caste are poor, that is Shudra caste. They serve other three castes, that is upper caste. And a person born in a particular caste could not change his job. And this leads to rigidity because the person or the child who got birth in a particular caste has to perform the same function that their ancestors have been performed or their father is performing. Lower caste people are denied of different opportunities, like they are not allowed to get a proper education. They are not allowed to go to some places. They are not, they face degrading conditions where they are not treated in a respectful manner. The higher caste people don't used to interact with them. And nowadays, the people who belong to the lower caste are known as the scheduled castes. So the next topic is that what was the struggle faced by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar against caste discrimination? And in the first point it says that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the pioneer against caste oppression, which means he was the first person who started raising his voice against caste discrimination. He also belonged to a poor low-caste family and was also treated as untouchable. He suffered from the same ill treatment which the other persons or the child faced in the lower castes. But he was able to attend school and he had to sit separately and was not allowed to talk to others or play with other students. Then, overcoming all these social obstacles, Ambedkar became the first untouchable to complete graduation in India. Then, he also went to New York for higher studies, and when he returned to India, he started a weekly journal called Mook Nayar, where he criticized the caste system. He demanded reservation for the Dalits. Then the third point says that he was the first law minister of independent India. So Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar later became the first law minister of independent India. We can say that he was the architect of the Indian Constitution, the written document for Indian laws. He was made the chairman of the drafting committee, which was given the responsibility of drafting a constitution for India. Then the last topic is that how diversity is shown in our Indian constitution. So the first point says that our constitution says that equality for all Indians, every Indian should be treated equally. With diversity in religion, language, dress, custom, tradition in the country, It is natural that there are differences of opinion on various issues, but the Constitution of India provides for a framework in which these differences can be resolved. The Constitution lists some fundamental rights which gives equality to all Indians. The second point is abolishing untouchability. The fundamental rights have also been aimed at overturning the inequalities in Indian social practices. They have been used to abolish untouchability and caste system. They also prohibit discrimination on the grounds of religion, race, caste, place of birth, gender. They provide religious freedom to all citizens of India, declaring India to be a secular state. They protect cultural and educational rights of ethnic and religious minorities. And to bring about equality in society, the Constitution makes special provision for the advancement of any socially or educationally backward class. Right to freedom of speech and expression gives one the right to freely express their views, and they can easily form association or unions. Constitution also provides the reservation facility for the Dalits. So students, these were the topics that we already studied in the main video of chapter 24. And today we have also done the revision. Students, in the first part of the same chapter video, there was one word over there that is vandalism. I explained the meaning of vandalism wrong. The meaning of vandalism is to destroy any public or private property willfully, or we can say deliberately. So this is the meaning of vandalism. So students, this was it for today's video. In the next video, we will start a new chapter, which will be of geography, chapter 15. Thank you.